These deer are wild and they have a mind of their own. So you have to work with what they're willing to give you and be comfortable with, or you're gonna have a disaster on your hands.
When you're working with whitetails, you just gotta expect the unexpected. You never know what's gonna happen.
You always have to be on high alert because ultimately these are wild animals and they can be unpredictable really quick.
This is Doug Roberts. He's raised some of the largest typical whitetails in North America. His farm produces the best hunting scents in the world. His life's quest is 200-inch typical whitetails. This is ConQuest 200. On this season of ConQuest 200, new life begins.
If you have to grab a fawn, grab her on the midsection, let the legs hang, let the head hang, you're not hurting them. And then simply take them where you have to and let them go.
With over 140 newborn fawns, the top priority of the farm is the health of the herd. Farming whitetails is no easy task.
You're dying to get worms,
right? It takes a team of dedicated employees to do this work.
Hey, what are we supposed to do?
A team that's willing to step in while Doug goes in for surgery.
Tired of the pain, tired of not being able to do what I need to do, so.
With knee surgery complete, violent storms hit the farm, knocking down trees and jeopardizing the perimeter fence. All the deer need to be accounted for, especially the breeder bucks. Just when things seem to be getting back to normal, the farm gets a surprise inspection from the state.
Has anything ever escaped in the last 3 years?
With inspections on the farm to emergencies off the farm.
Tyler just got in a car accident.
If you don't have no insurance.
It goes from one thing to the next, and darting bucks is on the list. This common practice allows Doug to treat certain deer with illness. The alternative is running the deer into the facility. From saving sick bucks to the collection of semen from others, making the right genetic combinations is the key to the breeding program.
This is 10-7.
Unless you have a missing doe.
She didn't jump a wall or anything going with the yearling, did she?
It's just another day on the deer farm.
Father in heaven, we come to you today thanking you for all the blessings you've given us, and I pray that we would be a blessing in return to protect our animals and our workers today. I pray in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Good morning.
Just like every other morning on the Whitetail Farm, Doug and Karen Roberts say a quick prayer and start their day.
Well, I grew up working on farms, and I also grew up with my dad whitetail hunting every year and looking so much forward to doing that and spending that time with him. And so when I was able to actually take the love of farming and the love of the whitetail deer and put it together into deer farming, that was the best of both worlds. But every day, water, feed, and fence, automatic first thing we try to do every single day.
Over the past 20 plus years, ConQuest Deer Farm has raised some of the largest typical genetics in the country. One of those particular bucks is ConQuest, As a yearling, he was 172-inch typical and took first place at the Nadifa Antler Competition. As a two-year-old, ConQuest took fourth place at 205 inches. And as a three-year-old, he came back and took third place at 225 inches. ConQuest is one of the deer that they are building the genetic foundation off of and even named the farm after him. For 23 years, Doug Roberts has been farming whitetails. His quest? To grow the largest typical buck in North America. One of Doug's genetic lines is from a buck he named the farm after, ConQuest.
When I put the combination of genetics together, the mother and the father, in my mind I have a good idea of what should turn out and what I'm trying to change in the characteristics of the antler structure of those offspring. But in the end, it really comes down to Mother Nature. Do those combinations work? And then it takes time to see that structure come out of those little fawns.
This farm is more than genetics and raising 200-inch whitetails. It's a family farm that produces hunting scents distributed by all the major outdoor retailers. Each scent stick is poured, hand-inspected, packaged and shipped straight from the deer farm. But it comes down to the employees that help make this happen. Without them, none of this would be possible.
Hats off to the workers, to our team, because not only are they manufacturing and packaging premium scent products, but it all starts with the deer and taking care of the deer and all the chores that have to be done on a daily basis. And then get back in the building and get your quota done for manufacturing as well. So we have a great team, and they love what they do, and they're passionate about it, and it shows in their performance.
Meet Heather Roberts, daughter of Doug. She's been raising whitetail with her father since the beginning.
You gotta work on that.
She works behind the scenes, packaging scents and taking care of the whitetail year round to pay her way through college.
Farming whitetails is different. It's not just like your average thing, I guess. There's not many people that do it. You know, it's different, especially since I've like gone to school like in the city. And then I come home and I live on a farm.
Good brother.
Yep.
Whenever I've been asked to describe Heather, one word comes to mind, and that's delight.
Put it on the ground. $400 for her.
She can shoot a gun. She's a great shot. She can come in and paint her nails and do her hair.
Nice day we're having.
And then you can call her out on the farm and she'll pour pee. I mean, the girl will do whatever has to be done.
Two scoops.
Like full? Yep.
That's good, yeah. And you wanna do it really close to the water.
And at the same time, there's always a smile on her face.
What was that over? Yeah, just go take your afternoon nap up there, old man.
I will while I'm doing this. I'm making fun of you guys employed.
So here you have the guys working outside all day on the deer farm. Right now we have a big delivery of containers, so it's get them off the farm, get them on the tractor, the front load, and the high low, and get everything unloaded like pronto, because the driver's also waiting to get on his next delivery as well.
With 50,000 containers to be filled with deer pee, the demand of producing deer scents at ConQuest is at an all-time high. With Doug on the farm producing scent, it's Karen's job to deliver the final product to the customer.
I'm pretty pumped. First thing I do is open up a box and take a look to see, is it really the right thing? And yay, it is!
As president and CEO of ConQuest Scents, Karen Roberts has taken her work ethic and drive to build and brand a company with proven results. From working with reps on large store orders to the one-time shopper, everything starts and ends with Karen.
When it comes down to the end of it, you know, the saying is, behind every good man, there's a great woman. Karen's that great woman that holds not only this family together, but the business together and allows me to do what I need to do as far as the deer farm and keep building it and keep it going forward and improving itself.
Deer farming is farming, yes, but it's deer farming. It's a totally different realm of farming, and it is who we are, it is what we do, it is how we live our life.
Many would view this farm as another high-fenced hunting ranch, but on ConQuest Deer Farm, they focus on two things: raising the world's leading typical genetics and producing the world's best hunting scents.
During our busy season, making products, starting from running the deer in, collecting the urine, it comes into our building where we manufacture everything from packaging, from pouring, to labeling, you know, and shipping. It all happens here. It comes right from our farm, so we're all hands-on.
Here at the farm, that much more rewarding when we get testimonials back from a customer that may have harvested the biggest buck that they've ever seen.
Every single day we have packaging. It's just hectic. I know, like, living with my parents still, like, they, at the end of the day, they're still going.
There's no template. There's no given. It's always gonna be different every time you're out there working with them.
The structure of the farm has been created to keep the natural instincts of the white-tailed deer completely ingrained into the animal itself. Our farm has been set up with a series of runways, which allows us to open gates at different times from different pens and give them escape routes, just like they would have naturally in a wild environment, where they feel that there's pressure from one area and they know they can release and sneak out of the area going through some other way. But we have them directed into the runways, into the direction that we wish they would go.
You have to be alert at all times. If you let your guard down for even a split second when you're going out of a gate and you might think you chained the gate shut but you accidentally didn't, you're gonna have a whole pen full of deer that are running all over the place.
People can get seriously hurt, especially with the bucks. It's really dangerous with the bucks if they're coming in with their antlers. I mean, you see deer on like TV shows and magazines and you're like, wow, that's a huge buck. Okay, well, have it come charging at your face.
We got one doe that won't go in.
Here I come.
All the pens on the outside are 10 foot and everything on the inside is 8 foot because deer can jump 8 foot. So it gets a little scary when you're running them because you know they can jump right on over you.
Okay, she's in.
When you're working with white-tailed deer, you automatically know that things are gonna happen unexpectedly. But when the unexpected happens, it's very important that you actually get calmer when things get more chaotic. You know, we move large groups of deer into the facility. One, we do it for the scent collection, but then we also do it for the separations of fawn when we do them in weaning time in the fall. We also do it for artificial insemination when we bring the does in and we work on the genetics or enhance the antler structure of the herd that we have. So those are the number of different ways and times that we move large groups of deer directly into the farm and handle them.
We are passing the breed pens right now. Every single doe in these pens have been either artificially inseminated or bred naturally.
We've raised our children. They know how to handle the deer. It's just second nature to them. It's hard for us to all be able to get away together because somebody's always got to be here, and it can't be just anybody. It can't be just a neighbor or a friend that can come in and do the chores. It has to be somebody that can handle themselves and understand the dynamics of deer behavior.
Talon Hodgson, son of Karen Roberts, knows all too well the dangers of whitetail farming and has learned from his mistakes while running deer into the facility.
We have runways going all over this farm, but yet this is the most dangerous spot right here. We have three corners. These two corners are pretty bad.
but the next corner down here, right before they run into the barn, I call that the suicide corner because you have no idea where they're at. I broke my nose a couple years ago, but we have runways everywhere, and this is the worst spot right here.
It's fun to be here. It's fun to, you know, be surrounded by all these animals every day. And I also work as a registered nurse at a hospital, and I work in the psychiatric unit, so this is kind of relaxing for me to be here, even though it's considered work.
As a former student of Doug's, Nate Walton views the work on the farm as relaxing. Compared to his full-time job as a registered nurse in a psychiatric unit, Nate is responsible for the care of the whitetails and is often found in dangerous situations.
Need a break? That was a nice little warm-up.
Doug's quest for 200-inch bucks, that's what he's been doing for 20-some years.
31,000 so far. A bottle fed doe.
When everybody got on the bandwagon of growing these 400-inch two-year-olds just to go for score, Doug was one of the only few that stayed with 200-inch typicals.
The number one thing that drives me is to be able to grow and create 200-inch typical whitetails. They are the perfection of what God created. In my mind, that is, there's nothing greater than a whitetail deer, one that can make 200 inches, the big 6x6 typical look. That typical look to me is just what trips my trigger. You know, you walk up to a brand newborn fawn and you find out it's a little buck fawn, and the first thing in my mind pops in is, this could be the next ConQuest. This could be bigger than ConQuest himself.
Finally, a reality series on whitetail deer. Join us this season on ConQuest 200, when breeding whitetails and manufacturing scent products collide. Go into the daily lives of Doug and Karen Roberts as they show you their Michigan whitetail farm. From the spring season and birth of fawns to the weaning and tagging process, you'll experience the summer months of growing antlers to the breeding season in the fall. See firsthand the scent collection process that produces their number one seller, Evercom, and their most powerful estrus scent, VS1. From winter snowstorms to trade shows, find out what buck will be crowned number one in North America at the NADIFA. Will it be the buck they've named Die Hard? Or Exeter? Or will Crusader sweep the competition for the second year in a row? From field trials and launches of the next ConQuest scent products, to the everyday life, you'll see it all here on ConQuest 200.
Go, 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 go.
Stay tuned for scenes of next week's episode.
From the time we collect semen and we artificially inseminate that doe, and she's sent back out to her pen, we know life has begun. It's really amazing if you think about it. And then we get to anticipate that pregnancy with her until birth happens in the spring We're all like expectant parents here, waiting for that birth to happen and see life start again.
For more info and behind-the-scenes action, visit ConQuest200.com.
Come on! Come on! Hey! Keep coming!
Yep.